What's going on, guys? In this video, I'm going to show you guys a really cool text effect in PowerPoint. So without further ado, let's get started. All right, so here is the text effect. If I go into presentation mode, and then as you can see here, this text pops up behind the cityscape of this image and still in the background. It looks really cool. You can obviously move this text to be up a little bit higher, lower, whatever you want. But I want to show you guys how I was able to pull off this text coming behind the background of this image of the actual buildings. Now, normally you might not see this in a PowerPoint presentation, but I want to show you how to achieve this effect in just a couple of minutes. So here's what you do. I'm going to pull up Unsplash right here. I just typed in city. And then what you do is look for a city picture you like. So in this case, I picked this one. Now, mind you, this is probably not going to work for any type of image because it could be extremely detailed and it just won't work. So try to find something where the background of the cityscape is maybe a little less complicated. That's kind of why I chose this one in particular. This one, I can maybe see it working out. Like if you want to get that sky to be disappeared, that maybe could work. This one, maybe. This one, maybe. This one definitely could work. So you kind of have to be selective of which city image you pick. And it could be any other type of image as well if you want a different type of landscape. All right, so if I want to include this image, I'll just download it right here. And then click and drag it in. Bam, we got our image. Now, let me put this on a new slide just so you guys can see. So we're gonna put our image in like so, and we will increase the size to be like that. Great, we have our image. Then we need our text. So in this case, I'm just gonna copy and paste this text over. I use Lato Black. You can easily add a text box by just going up to shapes, adding a box like so, and just typing in cityscape, or whatever text it may be that you want. Increase the size of it by doing Control Shift greater than sign, and then you can change the font to be Lato Black. Okay, and then I added a text shadow. Make sure you have no shape fill in this case. All right, so that's what I did. Obviously, I made it a little bigger than what I had, but you get the gist. So that's how you make that text right there. Then what you'd want to do is if you want to animate the text, you can. If you don't want to animate the text, don't follow this step. Skip to the next step. So to animate this text, all you have to do is go click on this text, go to animations. I have multiple animations here. So you'll see that I have a fade animation and a line animation. So in order to do that, I'm just going to copy and paste this real quick and remove these two animations. So I'm going to click on this text right here, click on fade, great, and I'm going to take previews off, and then I'm going to add another animation. When you add more than one animation to text, you need to go over to this pane right here. Do not click it over here, otherwise it'll get rid of your first animation and add the second one, but only the second one, not the first one as well. So add a second one, you have to go over here, click lines, then we're gonna go up. And in this case, as you can see here, when I had it right here, here we'll just put it over to the right here, just to demonstrate. So I'm going to basically have it start right down here and then click on this red dot to have it end up right where the text is. And then have both these with previous. You can move this fade one off a little bit, but in this case, it doesn't really matter because it's already hidden behind the city and it will fade in slowly. But let's say maybe you want to have like a very slow fade in. So let's see how this works. All right, so here, you're not gonna see it. Let me show you right here. All right, so now let's see what this animation looks like. So I'm going to actually delete this one right here because it's the same exact one as this one. And I'm going to play it. Awesome. So that looks really cool. But here's the problem. We still have this image right here and we have our text and it's not coming behind the city like we want that effect to do. So what we can do is basically make sure you remember where you got that image from. So we got this image from Unsplash. Great. Well, what you can do is you can go to a site called remove.bg. I actually did a video on it right here if you haven't seen that already. and it shows you how to remove any background image. And what you want to do is you're going to just click and drag in that image. All right. Then what it's going to do is it's going to remove the background for you completely free. You don't need Photoshop. You don't need any other tool. Another way to do that is you could go in here and you could go picture, and then you could do remove background and try to do it this way. People, that's going to take too long. Okay. So if you don't have to do this method, don't do it. But in this case, if you wanted to, you could just mark the areas you want to keep and then try to, but it's going to get pretty rough looking for you guys. I'm not going to lie. Let's see if we get this right over here. Maybe a little bit.
2 hours later.
PowerPoint, I love you, but I'm not a fan of that method. So we're not going to do that. We're going to go back to the background remover, which is right here, and see how it removed the background for us. Nice and clean. Awesome. If you do want HD, keep this in mind. This is not HD quality. This is a lower quality. Here's the sizes of the actual image. If you want the full image, you're going to have to pay. Not the worst thing in the world if you have a couple of dollars to spend, but in this case, for just demonstration, I'm going to show you guys what the free version looks like. So I'm going to download that. All right. So then what you're going to want to do is you want to click and drag this into PowerPoint. So it's going to show up right here. And then just to line it up, all you have to do is line it up like so, move it there. And now let's see what this looks like in presentation mode. Woo! Look at that. You guys just made a super cool effect in just a couple of minutes. By having text come behind the background of a cityscape, it's a really cool effect. Not a lot of people are doing it in their PowerPoint presentations, and you may be able to impress other people by pulling off this cool effect. So if you did like this video, make sure to give it a thumbs up, and if you could subscribe, I would greatly appreciate the support. Also, if you are also interested in learning all things about PowerPoint, I do have a course on Udemy, so I have a link to that in the description below. But without further ado, I hope you guys have a great rest of your day. And I hope to see you guys in future videos. Thanks.